Maybe it was the rainy weekend here in Washington, but President Trump spent his time firing off dozens of tweets and dozens more retweets to his 60 million followers. One of the president's rants sparked a Twitter tirade from conservative lawyer George Conway, the husband of top Trump advisor Kellyanne Conway. Brian Todd has been looking into this for us. So, Brian, what's the latest on all of this?
Well, something about the president's tweet over the weekend blasting the Russia investigation really set George Conway off. Tonight, Conway's blistering attack is being talked about all over this town, and many are wondering just how and when this feud is going to escalate.
Good morning. I hope everybody...
He just may be the biggest thorn in Donald Trump's side, or at least his Twitter feed. George Conway, conservative legal scholar and husband of Trump's top aide, Kellyanne Conway, you might say has become the lid to Trump's ego. On Sunday, he was back at it, calling the president a narcissist after Mr. Trump again blasted the Russia investigation, tweeting, quote, "Think of it. I was under a sick and unlawful investigation concerning what has become known as the Russian hoax." Trump's tweet storm led to a nine-part tweet NATO of sorts from Conway. Playing off Trump's opening line, Conway responded, "Think of it. The Russia investigation was a legitimate investigation. It was in the best interests of the nation. But because you are a malignant narcissist, a person with both narcissistic and antisocial personality disorders, you couldn't view it that way."
George Conway has taken it upon himself to be in the spotlight as the husband of the counselor to the president. He knows that he can make this case to the public and it will get more attention than your garden variety lawyer.
But George Conway wasn't finished. He tweeted to the president, "You took multiple steps to obstruct and repeatedly lied about the investigation from the outset. You put your own perceptions of your self-interest above the national interest, which you seem unable to comprehend or respect. It is an offense for which you should pay with your office," a clear reference to impeachment. But why would the husband of a Trump confidant, a staunch conservative and high-profile lawyer, go out on a limb and call for the president to be removed from office? Those who know George Conway say it's a matter of principle.
I think that he is, first of all, being intellectually honest about what he is seeing in the president's conduct and in addition to the information that was contained in the Mueller report. I think he is trying to lead by example by saying this is something that conservatives should be speaking out about.
Conway has not been shy about speaking out. He recently helped establish Checks and Balances, a group of conservative lawyers who publicly question the president's adherence to the law. And he's been a blistering critic of Trump's since the president took office, delivering his best-known broadside on the Yahoo podcast Skullduggery.
You know, it's like the administration is like a shit show in a dumpster fire.
Despite his contempt for the president, those close to him say George Conway wants people to know it's not about his marriage, but about his morals. Conway has been careful to keep his spouse away from his snubs. The president, however, has not.
"I don't know him. He's a whack job. There's no question about it. But I really don't know him. I think he's doing a tremendous disservice to a wonderful wife."
Tonight, analysts say George Conway can expect to come under further attack from the president and his allies.
"I think George Conway can take it. And I don't think that the Conways are about to get divorced. I think that they have made their peace with their difference of opinion."
Political observers are convinced we've certainly not heard the last of George Conway on all of this. Where does he want to take it? Well, George Conway did not respond to our request for comment. Analysts believe he probably wants to light a fire under the Democrats in Congress to move more decisively against the president. And they say he probably wants to influence voters in 2020. Neither Kellyanne Conway nor anyone else at the White House have commented on George Conway's latest tweet over the weekend. Wolf?
Interesting, Brian. Despite the efforts of Kellyanne Conway and George Conway to keep their political differences behind closed doors, a little of this has spilled out in public, hasn't it?
It has occasionally spilled out, Wolf. Now, back in March, George Conway told the Washington Post that he sent some tweets questioning the president's mental health, quote, "so I don't end up screaming at her about it." That was his quote. The Post also reported that Kellyanne Conway herself had told people at a party that she and Trump both think that her husband is jealous of her.